God bless the redial button.
You've reached the office of Commissioner Bill Mason, Oakdale Police Department. Our office hours are 8 a.m. to 5 p.m., Monday through Friday. Thank you.
The commissioner? So that's how they got into the jail to kill Clegg.
Tom, come on. What's the matter with you? You okay?
Yeah, I'm fine. I'm just a little wiped out.
Oh, man, why wouldn't you be? It's 7 in the morning. You've been up for 24 hours.
Yeah, well, so have you.
Then we have to get through that nightmare of a party, and you're worried about your mom, and I'm sorry.
Well, parents, you know, what are you going to do?
You know, maybe you should just call Lisa.
I'm not going to do that. You know, it's early, and I don't want to wake her up if she's sleeping.
All right. Thanks, by the way.
For?
We're not going off on John. I know you're furious with him.
And so are you, so why rub it in?
Golly, honey, I gotta tell you, sometimes marriage is a dandy institution.
Well, there's nobody I'd rather be hunting bad guys with than you, sweetie. So.
Even though we struck out here. You know, if Jess just hadn't held up that search warrant, I was sure we were gonna find enough illegal arms here to start a war.
Yeah, no arguments here.
So who moved him? I mean, it's a cinch that Clegg didn't do it from jail.
Well, whoever Clegg was working for probably had this house cleaned out and probably got to him in jail so he wouldn't talk.
I don't get it. How could anyone get to him in jail? Yeah, I thought we'd find something, anything here to link the gun runner to someone in Oakdale.
You coming or not?
Yeah. It's a waste of time, so what do we do now?
I think we should talk to Jessica.
You know what? I'm gonna make that call. Arnold Sims, please. Arnold, it's Tom Hughes. Yeah, message unit details. I need a printout. All the calls that were made from this phone in the last month.
Morning.
Morning.
What'll it be?
Coffee for sure, scrambled egg whites, and some dry whole wheat toast, please.
This guy's the DA. Give him some hash browns, too, and serve him over here.
Well, it's not the police commissioner.
You want the hash browns?
Well, he is the police commissioner. I guess I do, huh? Nice to see you.
See the papers this morning?
Oh, I knew the press was going to run with it. They were all over me last night.
Oh, I'm sorry. Somebody in the department screwed up good. I don't think that prisoner get strung up. What's his name? Clegg?
Yeah, Clegg.
Well, I called in Munson last night and gave him hell, along with the other officer involved.
Yeah, the other one. That would be my wife.
Now, I wasn't going to bring that up, Tom. Anyway, it's Munson's division. He'll take most of the heat.
Well, doesn't look so good for my office either. You know, I think I could have turned Clegg. I think he would have talked and told us who he was working for.
Well, I'm not gonna talk now.
Kind of a black eye for the police department, too, you know. I mean, homicide in jail.
Suicide?
Yeah, that sure is what it looked like at first.
He hanged himself in his cell.
Yeah, right, with his belt. I mean, that is what we thought. Then we went through his personal effects, and there was his belt, which was taken from him at the time of booking. So where did the second belt come from?
Well, it's not enough to make a murder case.
Oh, it's more than enough. I'd get internal affairs on it yesterday. The upside to the whole thing is that nobody knew much or cared much about Clegg, so the press isn't going to stay on it forever.
Well, you turn up anything in that house last night?
Squat. But what do you expect? It took us so long to get the warrant, anything that might have been there was long gone.
Well, damn that Judge Morrison. Should have been in there right after the bust.
Yeah.
So we've got nothing.
No, we know that Clegg was murdered so he wouldn't talk. So if I can find out who killed him, I'm gonna get them for running illegal arms into Oakdale.
Friend, time for a coffee break.
Actually, it's not. You look tired.
I am. I've been up for 24 hours.
Yeah, well, I didn't get much sleep either, and I have a lot of work to do this morning.
We appreciate the fact that you're busy, which is why we really thank you for fitting us in.
I don't think I did.
Hey, did the appointment we have this morning.
What appointment?
You didn't call? You were supposed to call. You didn't make the call? You were supposed to call.
That's my appointment book, Margot.
Oh.
So do we have business to discuss? I don't think so. I'm no longer representing anyone in police custody.
That's a wise choice since your client is dead. But that's the good news. Bad news, it was a murder. Of course, you already know about the two belts, so this isn't news to you at all.
Including the fact that this is now a homicide investigation.
Which happened under your noses, so if you want a lead, I suggest you talk to someone in the police department.
You know, it's kind of weird that you don't seem too interested in why your client was killed.
I was hoping you would find that out.
Jessica, why aren't you helping us? What are you worried about? These two lawyers are scum. Don't you want to know what they've gotten you into? Do you know?
Do you have a question about the homicide?
Yeah.
Who killed Clegg?
Do you know?
No, I don't.
Any theories?
No. I'm just glad I'm off the case.
But not off the hook. Jessica got a message at the party last night. I don't think she wanted me to see it. It was really kind of a cute message. It was written on a little cocktail napkin underneath her drink.
Tell me about the
waiter delivered
it.
It said, consider yourself still on retainer.
Is that true, Jessica?
Now, I assume that it had to come from Quinlan in Switzer, but you see, your client's dead, so the question would be, who the hell are you still representing?
I'm on retainer to Quinlan and Switzer for any legal work they deem necessary here in Oakdale.
Any legal work? God, that could cover a hell of a lot of ground.
Yes, it could.
Is there anything that you won't do? Anywhere you draw the line?
Come on, Jessica. Aaron Clegg is bringing illegal firearms into Oakdale. We know he's not doing it on his own. He's got these two sharks working for him. Why?
They were his attorneys.
Before they hired you as local gun.
Who are they working for, Jess?
I couldn't tell you.
We need to know.
I don't know. I've never spoken to anyone other than those two.
And they never explained their tremendous interest in getting Aaron Clegg out of jail?
No.
And you just don't give a damn? It never occurred to you to ask who you were working for? Who they're working for? Aaron Clegg was a racist pig. He treated you like garbage. Since when do you take that, Jessica? And I've seen you with those two sharks. I've seen the way they talk.
Hal.
I can see that you're scared, Jessica. Why? Are they threatening you?
No, and you better stop making accusations.
Why are you doing this, Jessica?
Jessica.
Have they got something on you?
You wouldn't do it voluntarily. We know that. Tell us what's going on. Help us so we can help you.
I've told you everything I can. I have to take that. Will you show yourselves up? Yes. Oh, no, I'll take it now. Hi. Honey, calm down. Calm down. Calm down. Calm down. Just tell me what happened.
These are not egg whites. Never mind. So you're right, Commissioner. If I can't get anything on the homicide, then I will have to drop the weapons charge.
Well, it's too bad you struck out on searching the house.
Yeah, not a solitary fingerprint in that place. But Clegg didn't kill himself. Somebody got to him in jail.
Well, you know the kind of screwballs and dopers we're holding down there these days. Who knows what he did to get himself taken out?
Yep, who knows? But, he'd have been a good witness. Have to, wish me better luck next time, Humbert.
You bet.
Have a good one. Hmm.
Commissioner, there's a call for you on the payphone.
Thanks. Commissioner Mason.
Commissioner, Phil Riley at the phone company.
Yeah.
Thought you'd want to know. The DA requested MUDs on a phone this morning. JK5-5510. One of the calls is to your office.
Okay. Thanks.
Hey, your friend didn't touch his breakfast.
They didn't come here to eat.